So over time, there has been lots of different productivity systems and methods that have been released out to the world, and many of them are great frameworks to planning and organizing your time. Not all of them will work for you, but in today's video, I wanted to rank them based on my opinion, and it was a great way to try and teach you as potential beginners to productivity about systems that you can implement every single day and chop and choose which ones you want. Welcome, my name is Francesco. I'm excited to dive into this video. If you're new, hit subscribe. We cover apps, tools, software, and even guides like this if you fancy it. I've got a resource in front of me that helps me to rank stuff. So the top tier are gonna be the ones that are super helpful, and the bottom ones are gonna be ones that are not so helpful. But obviously this is my opinion, so choose as you like as we go through this list. So our first one on the list is Getting Things Done by David Allah. Now, Getting Things Done is a really interesting technique. It's a five-part process that you can go through to essentially capture things and then action them later. Now, it is developed in the 90s, so it's a little bit too rigid these days in my opinion, but the application I definitely think should go just above the top tier, because in its essence, GTD has loads of systems inside of it that can help you to be more productive. And very simply, I recommend it to most people that are looking to get started with productivity, because it's a timeless system. It works in today's society, which is amazing. Probably not in 10 years, but at the same time, really, really helpful for the next 10 years at least. Now, what I would say about this one is the reason why I didn't put it top tier is because I would probably say it's quite intense and people tend to take it quite by like a Bible approach. So I would say be a little bit more open with that. I use GTD, but I really do use a relaxed version of GTD. The systems are great, the framework's great, added on top of a productivity application, or added belief a productivity application as a framework. So next up, another system called the Pomodoro technique. This is developed by somebody called Francesco as well. I mean, we just create systems, don't we? It's a time management system that you can use essentially setting a 25-minute timer and having a 5-minute break. You do 4 cycles of this, and then you can have a longer break. And I think this is a really effective technique that pretty much a lot of people don't use. Now, what you can do with this is essentially use this routine to help plan in breaks and use it in the office to even set periods of time when you're working and focusing. And what's great as well, you could even time your Pomodoro timers with other people as well, so that you can take longer breaks with them, have more planned breaks and systems. So I actually rate Pomodoro timer as even higher than GTD, because I feel like timers are a great way to push the focus of work, get into deep work states, and really enhance those pieces of work that you're doing. Next up is the 80-20 rule, and it's also known as the Pareto Principle. Now, many people know of this one because it's widely talked about. It's active doing 20% of the work that produces 80% of the outputs. My wife hates this because I do it in the household cleaning. I leave certain bits of the hoovering because it's the 80-20 rule. But very simply, this can be a great way to take that sort of concept of perfection out of your productivity. A lot of us tend to try and get something 100% done, whereas I think sometimes getting things 80% done with that concept in mind can actually produce better outcomes in the long term, because at least you're not focusing on that 100% perfectionism and you can really chisel it later. It's something that I've benefited from a lot in my work, and I think the system is really good. So I rate it as a high tier system. Next up is a concept by Brian Tracy called Eat That Frog. And it's not literally eat that frog. It is very simply the concept of eating the most difficult task at the start of your day. And for many of us, we put off the tasks that are hardest because we want to procrastinate, or even just we don't want to do it. And I've really embraced Eat That Frog as a concept the last couple of months, taking the toughest thing I don't want to do at the start of the week, at the start of the day, and it's really, really hard to do. But at the same time, it scores the most points when it comes to knocking dominoes over to other tasks that you do at the end of the week. So I rate Eat That Frog highly. Something like Pomodoro timer doesn't get used enough, and something I think that a lot of people will start to improve their productivity by the end of the week because they've completed the toughest things first. And you've got the most mental fatigue probably at the end of the week, so it's much more difficult. So top tier system there. Next up is the bullet journal method by Ryder Carroll. This is a concept that is much more complex than I can explain in a video, but very simply it's using bullets to journal, but also to plan your tasks and plan your system in a book or a journal and use those systems to plan ahead with tasks and also activities and events. I quite think the system works very well for a lot of people, but I actually rate it as a medium level tier experience because I think it's very designed for visual people and those who tend to not like software. And I hate those people. No, I just think it's really designed for a set few. And sometimes, a bit like GTD, it gets you stuck on a system too much, whereas I think you should be a bit more flexible with it. So I think flexible bullet journal system works. So that's why I rank it as a mid-tier, as on the old chart of things. Next up is a concept called the 12-week year. And this was a book written by Brian Moran and Michael Lennington. Essentially, this book helps you to plan your goals in a 12-week cycle, which is 3 months, instead of the yearly typical cycles that we see. This is something I referred to in a recent video about 2024 goal planning. And I think it's a great system because what it does quite nicely is actually sets the standards a lot more intense. And yearly goals are tough because you can develop so fast over a year. So why not set something a little bit more in vision? You can see March, maybe at the end of March, you can see those goals, maybe they're much more approachable. So almost top tier, very close to top tier system in my opinion. Next up is the time blocking methodology. This again is a super underrated activity that a lot of people don't do. And it's very simply going to your calendar and dragging time on there instead of using a to-do list experience or using it with very tightly with a to-do list experience. Now, there are many apps that can help with this, but largely the system is underutilized. And I think a lot of people will find it beneficial to use calendar blocking or time blocking, as many people call it. And I rate this very close to the top as a system. Next up is the Eisenhower Matrix. And again, a very useful system, but really designed for people who are really struggling with their prioritization in task management. It's really more of a decision-making tool about prioritizing your tasks. It's really great for if you're stumping yourself and you can't really move past prioritizing your tasks. And it's a great way to set up the delegation and things like that. And really determine what a task is useful for, whether it's urgent or important, and to really evaluate that. So I think it's a really good system, but I wouldn't rate it as top tier because it's more of a tool in the moment when you're struggling with them versus a full system like the others. Finally, let's just hit on this one. It's called the Bento Methodology. We've created the Bento Methodology. It's basically a prioritization system like the Eisenhower Matrix, but it forces you into 3, 5, or 7 tasks a day with large, medium, and small ones. I rate this system not so great. I think this one's great if you're somebody that struggles with prioritization, but needs to use it as a tool in a period of time. So we've actually got a course on this, so you can find it below. But largely, the Bento system is used by a lot of people that just want to be able to get task prioritization right. And very much like the Eisenhower Matrix, is designed to be more day-to-day. So I rate it on the same scale as that Eisenhower Matrix. That's a bold statement, isn't it? But at the same time, I think it's a very useful system that we've made. So they're some of the biggest productivity systems out there and what they are and how you can use them. So hopefully this video helped. Maybe in the future we'll do some videos at which apps are good for individual systems. Let me know if you want to have that in the comments below. And hopefully it was helpful in helping you to find a system that works for you. So if you're new, make sure to subscribe and I'll see you again in a future video. Here's some more that you can watch after this video. Cheerio.